Welcome, everybody, to the 2020 Hoop Hall Prep Showcase at American International College in Springfield, Massachusetts, with Coach Mike Burns. I'm Jeff Dooley, and, well, we got a bunch of games for you today as some of the best prep schools in the country are here in Springfield. And, Mike, game one, Sunrise Christian School out of Bel Air, Texas, opposite Scotland Campus Sports out of Scotland, Pennsylvania. What can you tell us about these two teams?
Sure. It's going to be a great matchup. Sunrise out of Wichita, Kansas, 18-5. Great win yesterday against Mount Zion out of the D.C. area. Sunrise did a great job changing defenses, got behind early, made a big run late. I'd keep an eye on Kieta, their big kid, number 15, big-time prospect. Scotland, coached by Chris Chaney, over 700 wins. They're 20-2. They had a decisive victory yesterday over Mount Verde. Prep, very, very talented team. They got a guard going to Iowa State, Dunbar, number 5. And the kid really helped himself yesterday was Terrell Strickland, number 11, was the MVP of the game. So it should be an exciting game and should be fun basketball.
And this is really a hot spot for coaches. We've got coaches from all over coming in here this weekend making notes.
Yeah, just looking around, you know, I see a head coach at Iowa State, head coach at Dayton, see the staff from UMass, assistant coach, Coach Moore from UConn. So we must be sitting in the right place.
That's
good, right. Big-time basketball.
We got a pretty good seat and appreciate you joining us on Your View Television as well. So we're set for Jump, Sunrise in the Grays, and Scotland Campus Sports in the Blacks. Terrific games all day on Friday, all day on Saturday, and then this tournament will conclude here today as you see Sunrise win the tip, and away we go from AIC in Springfield.
Scotland, a very good defensive team, very, very physical. Coach Chaney's teams are known to sitting down, being defensive and very physical.
Michael Robinson tries to attack the rim, gets fouled on the play, and the whistle against Scotland Campus. Abu Asmani will get charged with the foul, and that will send Michael Robinson, a 6'7 Houston, Texas native, to the charity stripe.
I think fouls will be big today. I'm curious to see how the Zebras call the game. If they call it tight, we could have a lot of fouls called. You know, as a former coach, you like to see let them play a little bit because both teams are very physical and very talented.
Robinson misses the first. He will try to make the adjustment. He misses both here. And the rebound taken in by Jason Woodrich, a 6'7 forward from Ohio. First offensive possession for Scotland Campus, driving in, can't get the angle is Berry, and rebound taken down by Sunrise. Sunrise out of Bel Air, Texas, opposite Scotland Campus Sports from Scotland, Pennsylvania. As you see Sunrise drive in, and TJ Fritz with the layup. And it's Sunrise that strikes first.
Keep an eye on number 10, Woolrich from Scotland. Coach Chaney thinks he's the best shooter in high school basketball. Went on a run yesterday, made 5 threes. Here he is today, getting up shots.
Woodrich can't get the shot to go. Lawrence gets the rebound. A home run pass to Robinson, who cashes in at the opposite end.
We're going to see some athletic basketball today. Should be fun.
And a 4-0 start for Sunrise.
Different start for Sunrise today. They get behind pretty early yesterday against Mount Zion, but they came out ready to play today.
Lawrence Berry kind of driving against the defense. Leaves it for Osmani. Can't get the shot to go. Berry a hand on the rebound. Off to Dunbar. Drives in. Puts it off the window and in. And it's Dunbar who gets the first points of the game for Scotland Campus.
Talented kid going to Iowa State. Coach Robinson will be very, very excited to have him for the next 4 years at Iowa State.
That'll be a backcourt violation as Sunrise takes it in the backcourt. And Scotland Campus gets it back of the turnover.
Yep, it'll be interesting to watch the big kid Sunrise, Kieta, play against Usmani at Scotland. Two high major talented kids. It's going to be a good contest.
Jalen Zachary has the basketball. Gets it off to Dunbar. And a foul called away from the action, and Sunrise will get it back. Well, you're right, it's interesting to kind of get the feel of the officials and if it be a tightly called game or if they're going to let them bang a little bit.
Yeah, obviously the referees want to keep it under control, but let's let these guys play. You hate to see a great player get in foul trouble and spend the whole day on the bench.
Tommy Lawrence has it for Sunrise. As they'll attack the basket, 2 hour left. Robinson has it now. Gets it off to Fritz. Fritz over to Odin. Back to Fritz. Diagonal left. Here's Lawrence. Going to spot up from three. That's going to rim out. But the offensive rebound, Kanta has it. Boy, you mentioned him on the outset, Mike, and he's a guy that does have tremendous talent.
Huge upside. Really, really interested to see how and him, Usman, going at it today.
They'll throw the ball away. The little sunrise. It goes out of bounds, and Scotland Campus takes over on own. Jaden Zachary with the basketball. Off to Berry. Lawrence Berry has it now. Now to Usmani. Off to Zachary. Zachary's going to pull up just outside of that right elbow. Can't get the shot to go. Sunrise the rebound. There's Robinson ahead of the pack. Pulls up for the free throw line and hits.
Wow, big time basketball right there. Put his head down, drove to the lane, gets to the free throw line. Robinson makes two.
Sunrise by four, just getting going. Played 3 minutes here at AIC in downtown Springfield. Good to have you with us, along with Mike Burns. Jeff Tooley with you. Thanks for spending some time on this Sunday afternoon. We've got the first of four games for you, just underway. And Zachary works it inside. Now up top for Zachary. He's going to fire the three. Got the post touch and then back up top for the easy three.
Really like it when a big fella stays under control, the defense collapses, pitch the ball back out, wide open three.
6-5 to score with 16 minutes to play here in the first half.
Scotland showing a little 2-2-1 pressure back to man-to-man. Sunrise is going to have to take care of the basketball today the way Scotland likes to defend.
Odin tries the three, can't get the shot to go. Rebound handled by Zachary. Jaden Zachary, the 6'3 guard from Wisconsin.
Sunrise is going to have to stay out on Woolworths. His range, as soon as he walks inside the gym, he's ready to shoot it.
Tyron Lawrence gets to the steals. He takes it away from him. He will drive all the way in, and the ball tipped away. It goes out of bounds. Wow. How about that defensive play?
Yeah, big-time defensive play going the other way.
And take a look at that three, and nice job to get the post touch, and nobody really guarding that perimeter. He gets a good look at the basketball and sinks the shot.
Yeah, as we said, goes inside, collapses the defense. Shooter spots himself up, knocked down, wide open three. Little 2-2-1 pressure here for Sunrise as well. Let's see how Scotland handles this pressure.
Jalen Woodrich.
Strickland comes in the game for Scotland, was the most valuable player yesterday. Can really, really shoot the ball, brings a lot of energy, plays within himself.
Darryl Strickland bringing up the right sideline. 5'11 guard from Tampa, Florida. Left wing three by Norris Berry is off the side of the rim. No good. Goes out of bounds. It'll stay Scotland Campus ball. Two teams with very good records. Scotland Campus 20-2. And Sunrise Christian School 18-5.
You have talented programs year in, year out. They're putting up 20, 30-odd wins.
Osman goes to the bench as Muhammad Wieg will sub in for Scotland Campus.
Coach Cheney alone has had over 700 prep school wins.
Pretty impressive.
He's had some talented kids over the years. He continues to do a great job.
And Strickland with the basketball. He calls out the set play for Scotland Campus. Moves left, followed by Rodegaard on that left sideline. Gets it to Berry, who just missed the three. Right-handed dribble, returns the pass to Strickland, pulls up at the three-throw line, kisses it off the glass, no good. The ball tracked down in the backcourt by Berry.
Great effort on the offensive glass.
Now Strickland to three. Comes off the side of the rim, no. The rebound is taken in by Colin Moore.
Strickland coming off the bench, ready to score baskets.
Rodegaard tries the three and connects.
Oh, nice shot in the corner. Teammate kept his head up, found wide open for open three.
And just like that, it's a 9-5 lead, but how about Scotland Campus coming back with a triple of their own?
Coming right back at you. Sprint the floor, spot up, wide open three.
It's a one-point game.
Here's the pressure, 2-2-1 pressure out of Scotland. Going to go back into man. Sunrise is going to have to take care of the basketball.
Sunrise with it. With a one-point lead. Tyron Lawrence has it, the guard from Morgan County, Georgia. Gonna work the ball inside to Robinson. It goes out of bounds.
Yeah, you like it when the referees come together. Referee went under the basket, made a call. The guy out front saw a different, brought together, talked about it, got the call right, going the other way.
Mike, you coached in prep school. Talk about what these tournaments mean to the coaches and the players here when you really have a showcase in front of so many well-known coaches.
Well, today you have a team out of Pennsylvania and a team out of Wichita, Kansas that would never be able to play each other, you know, during the regular season. But when you have a tournament like this, you have all these great players from all around the world, not only the United States, all around the world, come together and play. So not only is it great here for the teams, but it's great for college coaches. They can come in and see these guys go head-to-head.
Strickland driving in, throws it up top for Dunbar, all alone for a three, and he gets it to go.
Well, great pass by Strickland, drive, get the defense to collapse. Dunbar spots up, wide open three.
Yellowstone Dunbar is committed to Iowa State, and he's scored a couple of field goals already for Scotland campus. He now has their first lead. Driving down the other side at Sunrise that goes in, and the ball poked out of bounds. Let's take a look again.
Great drive here. Pitch out, Dunbar wide open three, knocks it down.
We were talking before that a lot of the teams in college basketball played yesterday, and in these parts, not great conditions. We had some snowfall through the night, so a chance for some of the college coaches with an off day today to come down to Springfield and do some homework.
Yeah, a lot of Division I head coaches give Sunday as their off day because they play their league games usually on Saturday. So it's a great opportunity for them to come out here and see this great talent go head-to-head.
There's Scotland campus. Dunbar drives in, does a 360, hangs in the air, can't get the shot to go. Offensive rebound grabbed by Dunbar, pumps it up. He has the shot altered, and Sunrise comes away with it. Ahead is Moore. Moore drives in and gets the contact and the foul. A block called on Scotland campus. Let's take a look at the three again.
Corner three, the rim is kind. Changed that rim yesterday. We had that thing break down for us in the middle of a game, put a new one up, and got a nice friendly roll.
Timeout on the floor. We will step aside as well. 13:28 to go. It is Sunrise leading Scotland by a point here at AIC. You're watching the 2020 Hoop Hall Prep Showcase on UrView Television. We're from American International College in Springfield today. Jeff Julian along with Mike Burns. And, Coach, your thoughts on the first 7 minutes of this contest here today, our first of four?
Heavyweight fight. Both teams, you know, going head-to-head, physical defensively, pushing the ball in transition. Right now, threes. Have been a bunch of three-pointers that have got us this close, tight game here, 12-11.
Well, you mentioned the rim broke yesterday. It caused a delay during the game. And it shows you what type of athletes we have here this weekend. We'll get you a picture of that rim momentarily as we see Sunrise inbound. They'll chuck it into the backcourt as Michael Robinson has it.
Scotland coming out in a little zone here. Let's see if Sunrise attacks that zone. Look to go high post, short corner.
Tyron Lawrence with the basketball loses the handle and it's stolen away, picked off by Dunbar. There's Dunbar for Merriweather, drives in and a whistle and a foul.
Right. Like it when the little guy goes in there, goes against the big trees, gets himself to the free throw line.
There's the rim from yesterday, Mike.
My goodness, one of the forwards from Mount Zion swung on the rim a little bit yesterday, and it's safe to say we will not be using that one again.
Nope, you can retire that one. Merriweather going to the free throw line, the 6'1", 175 guard from Memphis. He makes the first one.
You like it when the little guards get in there amongst the trees, but you don't have to create contact. If you flip that ball up, that's going to be blocked. So did a great job drawing a foul, getting to the free throw line.
That free throw ties the game. He'll try to put his team up, and he does.
Little full-court pressure right here off that made free throw.
Scotland with a terrific defense, nearly causing a turnover, but Sunrise able to call the timeouts. We'll take it as well. 13:08 to go. It is Scotland by a point here in Springfield. To keep your athlete in the game, Now look at Scotland Campus Sports and head coach Chris Cheney. You said he's been around a while.
Yeah, been a tremendous prep school coach. Patterson in North Carolina, Laurinburg, North Carolina, coach in the Maryland area, and now he started this program here at Scotland probably about 5 years ago. And year in, year out, they're a big-time program. Made it to the championship game of the National Prep School Tournament last year, losing to Brewster. But year in, year out, he does a phenomenal job.
Sunrise with the basketball. Timer Jackson has it as Coach A.C. Makabu gets the substitutions in. There's a left wing three up the side of the rim by Kieta. And the rebound taken in by Scotland Campus.
Scotland did a great job speeding Sunrise up. Strickland picking up right where we left off yesterday.
Yeah, he sure is. Yep. Leesport is Strickland who nails the triple.
There he is. Great effort. He's always involved, always around the basketball.
You love to see someone active, don't you, as a coach?
Absolutely. He just comes in, brings energy, makes plays for his teammates. Would love to have a kid like that on your team.
A four-point lead now for Scotland. Sunrise will have the basketball. They're out of Bel Air, Kansas. Already 18 wins on the season. Tyron Lawrence walks it by the mid-four stripe as Sunrise Christian will set up. Scotland Campus back to defend. There's Jackson off to Robinson.
Both head coaches going into their bench right now. We're going to see who can get a lift going to their bench.
There's Kanta, drives in and scores, kind of elevated right over the defense that time and used all the 6'10 frame.
Yeah, as we said, high major, high ceiling for that kid. He's going to get himself a scholarship at a great school if he continues to play the way he is today.
Luis Bleachmore comes all the way from Sydney, Australia. Missed that three for Scotland Campus, and the rebound taken in by Sunrise Christian. There's Jackson. Through the hands of Lawrence, back to Jackson. Oden has it. Now post touch for Kieta.
Great shell defense here for Scotland's Campus. Pressure on the ball, great closeouts.
Robinson tries the long three. That was NBA range. Can't get it to go, and the rebound, Strickland.
Yeah, great defensive stand for Scotland, forcing deep shots for Sunrise.
There's Merriweather as he'll get to the Terrell Strickland. Merriweather turns the corner, drives inside, now dishes it off to Wigg. I'm going to get some space, fire one up from 8 feet. Can't get the shot to go. Rebound taken down by Noah Butler.
Another great defensive stand for Sunrise. Really like Kieta guarding that block.
Jackson with the basketball. Strickland 20 points, 6 assists, and 3 steals in the effort yesterday, as you see. Sunrise drive in and get the hoop. Scotland Campus driving in. You can't get the shot to go. It goes out of bounds. And wholesale substitutions for Scotland Campus.
Yeah, Merriweather's going to keep his head up. He may miss one of his teammates under the basket. You got to look ahead.
Just over 10 minutes to play. Half number one. Just getting going. Our first of a quadruple header here from Springfield at AIC. Sunrise with the basketball. Moore has it. Out of Jackson. Back to Moore. Lawrence gets the touch. Works it inside to Kieta. Trying to feel his way in. Elevates over the defense. Can't get the shot to go. Rebound taken in by Scotland Campus.
Yep. You see Sunrise trying to take advantage of that matchup problem there on the block. Kate, tonight move. Just got to finish that. Get that to go down.
And Zachary with the basketball. Off to Dunbar. Now Asmin drives in, can't get the shot to go, goes out of bounds, and good defensive stop. Yeah. Sunrise will take over with the game tied at 16 aside.
Yeah, Usmani's going to do a better job. Can't put that ball on the floor. He put it on the floor, little guards get down, reach in, turnover going the other way.
With the basketball, it is Sunrise. Oden has it. It's going to step into a three. Can't get the shot to go. And the rebound taken down by Osmani. He's got it ahead to the cutting. Zachary goes in for the dunk.
Very unselfish basketball. Woolridge throws the ball up the floor. Dunbar drop off. Dunk. 2 points.
He's got seven, and it's 18-16. Scotland in front. And Sunrise trying to respond as Moore has it. Gets it to Jackson, fires the three off the mark, and Scotland campus the rebound. Zachary up the left sideline. Zachary is going to throw it up top now for Woodward, who tries a three. That's no good. Learns the rebound, and Sunrise clears.
Good push and transition. That's a shot that Woolridge usually knocks down.
Tyron Lawrence, pretty good look that time. And a long two, but it rims out. And Scotland campus the ball now. There's Beasley in for the first time. Gets it off to Aswani, who puts it up and in.
Great drop off. Nice finish.
He's got his first hoop, and it's 2016.
Scarlett making a run right here. Sunrise is going to have a great possession. Knock down a shot.
There's Jackson driving in. Throws to Lawrence.
Scotland really picking it up here defensively.
There's Moore. Gets a good look from the right wing. Can't convert, though, on the triple. And Scotland with the rebound. There's Zachary. Drives in. Gets it up top for Baisley. Now a three by Dunbar will miss. Rebound Sunrise's timer Jackson ahead of the bunch. Feeds it to Moore. After the miss, Moore gets the offensive rebound, puts it up and in.
Yeah, little stick with it right there. Get yourself 2 points off that offensive glass.
Makes it a two-point game. She approached the seven-minute mark here in the first half. Dunbar with a steal. I should say Sunrise with a steal, and Tyron Lawrence goes coast to coast after he rips it away from the offense.
Yeah, takes it away from Dunbar right there. Dunbar's going to stop messing with that ball there at half court. He's going to throw the ball ahead, get into some offense.
And then a terrific basketball game. And the three misses, and going to take a look at that dunk earlier.
Yeah, Dunbar's going to do a better job. You can't be messing with the basketball there. Great job by Lawrence. Steal the ball, push it ahead. Easy basket. Keep an eye on that rim now.
We don't need another broken rim.
I mean, we're running out of them here.
20-20 the score with just over 7 minutes to play. Half number one. This is the first of four on Your View Television. Jeff Dooley, Mike Burns. Tom Poole directing today. Good to have you along on this Sunday afternoon. Colin Moore has the basketball. Gets it off to go to guard. Now Moore drives in.
Oh, my
opens up and
goodness.
All the way to the rim as he attacks the basket with a flush.
Wow. Da-na-na-na-na-na. I could send that one in right there.
That's
that could be a SportsCenter top 10 highlight right there.
22-20. Good way to give his team the lead. There's Scotland campus drives in. Count the basket and the foul. Wow, nice job. Jaden Zachary drives in and gets the hoop to go.
Great ball movement, athleticism. Top 10 ESPN highlight right there.
Pretty impressive. Meanwhile, Zachary goes to the free throw line, and his field goal ties the game, and he's got a chance now with his free throw to put his team ahead with just about 7 minutes to play here, half number one.
Just what we thought, competitive game.
Yep.
Heavyweight fight, two teams going head-to-head, throwing haymakers.
Second one is good. Well, free throw, I should say, is good. And it's a one-point lead for Scotland campus. Sunrise from Bel Air, Kansas with a basketball. T.J. Fritz has it. Off to Kieta. Now Jackson for Robinson. Jackson set to go, works the ball inside, and gets the easy basket.
Tough move, nice floater in the lane. Jackson for two.
24-23 the score. He's got four. There's Zachary. Now for Barry all along for a three, and it's nothing but net. Good look that time.
Yeah, too easy. Sunrise has got to fight over that screen. Can't give up easy looks.
Two-point lead now for Scotland campus. There's Jackson. Thought about the three. Drives inside. Now leaves it for Ruttegard, who tries the three. No good. Offensive rebound kept alive by Kieta. Now Fritz tries the three, front rims it. Long rebound Jackson as he keeps it alive for Sunrise Christian.
Scarlett's going to do a better job on the backboard. They shoot threes. You're going to have long rebounds. You got to make sure you get out there, contest, and rebound those long shots.
Jackson fires the three.
Well, three for a quarter. Three threes. All misses. Rebound goal the other way.
Woodridge has it. Off to Baisley. Works it to Osmin. Throws it up, but traffic can't get the shot to go. Good stop by Sunrise. Comes up with a board.
Yeah, Kate did a great job moving his feet, staying straight up, straight down. Great defense there on the block.
Here's Rodegaard. Throws up an air ball, and the rebound taken down by nice on Baisley. Baisley's got it. Gets it off to Berry. Fakes the handoff. Lawrence Berry continues the dribble. A 6'3 guard from Cleveland, Tennessee.
Oh, my goodness. I'd like to see that one again. That could have been a block call, but our zebra called it a charge.
So good job for Sunrise to get it back. Leads Kieto with a good job to establish position, take the hit, and take a look again at the next dead ball right now. Scotland Campus will inbound, and it's stolen away. Stolen by Timer Jackson. Jackson.
Great anticipation there. Defensively steal the ball.
Yeah, they get it right back. Meriwether off to Strickland. Now Berry has it with 19 to shoot.
Offense getting a little stagnant here. Scotland's going to get that ball out of the corner. Going to chain size the floor. Middle matchup problem here on the block.
As Berry drives in, can't get the shot to go. Wade grabbed the offensive rebound, and then a blocking foul in the hoop.
Yeah, Kieta comes out of the game, and Scotland goes to the offensive glass. Stick back for Wade. Let's look at that drive here. Let's see if that zebra got the right call. Let's see if that's a charge or if that moving. Ooh, my goodness. That's a little close right there. I don't know.
What do you look for in that situation, Coach?
Well, if you're the you're the referee, yeah, you're trying to make the right call, obviously, but it just happened so fast. We have the opportunity to see the replay. Right. And, again, those block charges are so difficult to get right or wrong. So we'll see.
29-24 the score. Scotland Campus leads Sunrise Christian. Here's Timer Jackson with it. Off to Rodegaard. Now Lawrence. Jackson. Drives in, floater in traffic, rolls around, no good. There for the offensive rebound, though, as Butler puts it up and in.
Yeah, both teams doing a great job attacking the offensive glass.
Three-point game. Here comes Scotland Campus. Strickland, free throw line extended, no good, but a foul.
Strickland always ready to attack the backboard, always ready to get in the paint, get the free throw line, floater, two free throws.
Lawrence Berry will wish luck to Tara Strickland, who goes to the line. And free throw is good. Let's take a look at that last tip.
Yeah, you got to like it. When that ball goes up, you're on the offensive end. I think it's a pass. Go and get it.
Mm-hmm. Four-point game now. The free throw, Strickland will knock the second one down and make it 31-26 as you approach the three-minute mark here of the half. Moore now for Robinson. Hands off to Butler. There's Lawrence. Lawrence throws into traffic, nearly stolen away.
Yeah, great job defensively right there. Scotland switching, like screens, force that drive to the baseline, turnover going the other way.
So Scotland Campus will see if they can cash in as they trail by five with 3:29 to go. Terrell Strickland, 5'11", guard from Tampa.
Sunrise switching it up a little bit here, going to a zone. This zone did a great job for them last night. They were down seven early, went to the zone against Mount Zion, and it changed the game. Right here, force a turnover. It's working for them again.
Angelo Santiago trying to get the ball inside, but it won't work. It'll be a turnover. Sunrise takes over, up by down by five. That's Tyron Lawrence with the basketball. Now Moore has it to the right elbow. Hand off to Robinson. Robinson drives in, loses the handle, batted away into the arms of Scotland Campus, but they get it right back. Got a sloppy play.
Yeah, that big's going to get rid of that ball right away. You really don't want to put him on the floor. Nice steal, but you're going to give it up to a guard in transition.
Michael Robinson, top of the key, tries the three. Can't get the shot to go. Sunrise, though, crashes for the rebound. Body's flying all over the place. Try to save that one for his team. Let's take a look at that last turnover.
Yeah, Sunrise, you know, gets out of control driving down the lane. Turnover, throw that ball ahead. Just throw it ahead, sprint the floor, get rewarded. Turnover, come back the other way. A little sloppy play right there.
31-26, it is Scotland leading Sunrise here at AIC. Back after this. Yeah, look at Scotland as Scotland Campus gets instructions from Chris Cheney and Jeff Dooley, Mike Burns here at AIC. And, well, Coach, you thought it'd be a terrific game. It's been just that here in the first 18 or so minutes.
Yeah, interesting to see what's going to happen in the last 2:42. Right now, Sunrise has a five-point lead. Scotland has a five-point lead. Let's see what Sunrise does coming out of this timeout. Out of bounds play coming here for Sunrise. Let's see if they go inside for Kieta. Scotland going zone out of bounds.
Lawrence gets it into Robinson.
Scotland in 2-3 zone.
One of the things in these two teams, the only two players that have committed, Dunbar, Iowa State, and Gerald Jarman, a Division II Clarion University. So for the coaches that are in here, I mean, you've got a chance maybe to gather some of these prospects.
Yeah, that's why there are so many coaches in the house.
Here's Scotland Campus. Jason Woodridge has it stolen away. Stolen by Lawrence, who goes coast to coast, and he slams it home with both hands.
Wow, super athlete right there. Scotland get a little sloppy with the ball. Got to be stronger, get a sprint through the catch. You can't let him jump in the passing lanes.
He makes it a three-point game. Scotland Campus says Chinese Chris Pupu tried to get the shot to go. And
wow.
Yes, it'll go. It looked kind of a floater. You throw up a prayer sometimes and it goes in.
Estonia in the house, comes right off the bench. He says, shoot, there are college coaches here. I'm going to go get a basket.
Mm-hmm.
Nice shot, nice move, nice floater in the lane. Scotland back in this 2-3 zone.
90 seconds to play here in the half. As Fritz tries the three, a little bit too strong, and the rebound taken in.
Great box out there by Scotland on that possession.
Chris Hupu has it, gets it to Barry. He tries the three, it's an air ball, and goes out of bounds. Let's take a look at the most recent defensive play, dunk.
Did a great job here in the passing lane. Jump through, steal, saw it, tack the rim. Lawrence, athleticism.
Kind of jumped the passing lane that time, and it worked to perfection.
Yep.
33-28, Scotland leads Sunrise. A minute to play now. Fritz tries the three, can't get the shot to go. He's missed a couple now.
Got to play inside out against that zone. You just don't want to sit there jacking up threes. Play inside out, try to get yourself a layup.
Wig with the ball inside, working against Kieta.
That's a matchup problem right there.
Kieta
defensively
kidding.
Is a grown man. He's going to do a better job there, Wag, of realizing Kieta's there. Ball fake, get that ball back out again. Kieta, great block, going the other way.
So it will be Scotland Campus basketball. We'll lob it in the backcourt, and Jason Woodrich will track it down. Ford from Beechwood, Ohio. Zachary with it. Zachary drives in and initiates the contact and a block called on the floor against Sunrise.
Wow, man. Great take right there. Kieta does a great job stepping up. I don't know. He may have his puppies moving right there. He called a block.
And going to the free throw line, it is Zachary, and he makes the first. There you go again, Coach.
Yeah, let's watch Kieta's feet, see if he's out of that restricted circle. Oh, my. I don't know. I may have missed that one. I may have had that one as a charge, but shooting two free throws.
Next one is no good.
Yeah, basketball gods reward you right there.
That's right. Sunrise with a rebound. Here's Tyron Lawrence, a 2020 student out of Morgan County, Georgia. Guard has it now. Back to Lawrence. There's a shake the defense. Kieta drives inside and gets the shot to fall through the orange circle.
Great move. Nimble, nimble move. Turn, square, jump hook, score.
Now on the other side with time expiring, her three will miss. And it will be Scotland that takes a four-point lead into halftime. We're at halftime. It is Scotland Campus 34, Sunrise Christian 30. Back after this here in Springfield.
Drone Racing League pilot Wild Willie is testing his skills on the scariest course imaginable. His mom's house. Fortunately, he's using panoramic Wi-Fi from Cox. Because even a 1 second delay could mean trouble for everyone. Wall-to-wall fast panoramic Wi-Fi from Cox. Wi-Fi at the speed of flight.
The right connection can open a world of curiosity for your child. With Cox, families that have a K-12 student and receive government assistance could qualify for low-cost home internet with Wi-Fi. That means more learning and more achieving. Qualify now. It's time to connect with Cox.
Come on in and discover the new Cox Solutions store. Experience a whole new level of in-home comfort. It's all right here at the Cox Solutions store. Discover, learn, and experience more.
Drone Racing League pilot Wild Willie is testing his skills on the scariest course imaginable. His mom's house. Fortunately, he's using panoramic Wi-Fi from Cox. Because even a 1 second delay could mean trouble for everyone. Wall-to-wall fast panoramic Wi-Fi from Cox. Wi-Fi at the speed of flight.
And we are at halftime, 34-30. Scotland leads Sunrise. And, well, Coach, talk about some of the things that jump off as we take a look at the statistics here in half number one.
Yeah, looking at the stat sheet here at the half, I would say the biggest thing to keep an eye on is right now Sunrise Christian is 2 for 15 for the three-point line, and Scotland is 5 for 13. And then also that charity stripe. Right now Scotland is 7 for 8, and Sunrise is 0 for 2. So that's going to be big in the second half. Going to defend that three-point line. Shooting percentage not very good either way. Right now you have Scotland 11 for 31. Shooting 35% from the floor, and Sunrise 14 for 34, shooting 41. So defense battle, like we thought, but that three-point line and free throw line is going to be really, really interesting to watch in the second half.
Yeah, the team's getting after it, rebounding. Sunrise Christian out-rebounding Scotland Campus, but it's close, 22-20 in that area.
Yep. Keep tacking the glass, get second-chance opportunities. If you're going to shoot a low percentage, let's go and get that ball off the backboard. If I'm out there and that ball goes up, I'm always going to the opposite side of the rim, try to get that long rebound, get yourself a stick back.
Seven lead changes for ties in half number one. A terrific first half. We'll take a break. Come back with more from AIC after this. We are at halftime.
Drone Racing League pilot Wild Willie is testing his skills on the scariest course imaginable. His mom's house. Fortunately, he's using panoramic Wi-Fi from Cox. Because even a 1 second delay could mean trouble for everyone. Wall-to-wall fast panoramic Wi-Fi from Cox. Wi-Fi at the speed of flight.
The right connection can open a world of curiosity for your child. With Cox, families that have a K-12 student and receive government assistance could qualify for low-cost home internet with Wi-Fi. That means more learning and more achieving. Qualify now. It's time to connect with Cox.
And we are back from Springfield, the 2020 HoopBall Prep Showcase at AIC. Jeff Dooley, Mike Burns, and Coach, what type of adjustments do you see both teams making here in the final 20 minutes?
Always interesting to watch the first 5 minutes of the second half. Have a four-point spread right now. We'll see if one team comes out, switches it up defensively. Really want to see if Scotland can get Woolridge, number 10, going. Had five threes last night in their victory. Right now is 0 for 2 for 3. So look for Coach Chaney. Maybe run a set piece for him and try to get him an open look.
So it's a four-point game, and it will be Sunrise to start the second half with the basketball. That's Sunrise and grays, some maroon running through in the white trim, and the Scotland Campus in the black jerseys and shorts. As we resume here in half number two, very entertaining first half, Coach.
Yep, Scotland comes out in their half-court defense, man-to-man.
Robinson with the basketball for Sunrise, gets it to Kieta. Back up top, Robinson. Now Lawrence drives in. Over Odin, tries the three. It's going to come up short. Go out of bounds. Was last touched by Scotland Campus. Yeah. It'll stay Sunrise basketball. Yeah.
As a coach, you love the little things. If you watch Woolridge close out right there, great closeout, hands high, forces the air ball.
Fitz has it now for Sunrise. Off to Robinson.
Scotland goes that 2-3 zone on their out-of-bounds defense. Wow.
Banks it off. Did he call that?
I did not hear him call that. Banks are usually closed on our Sunday, but I guess here in Springfield, we're going to open them up.
One-point game. Scotland Canvas will try to respond with their first offensive sequence here in the second half. You see the set that Chris Chaney comes up with. There's Dunbar driving in, but had the ball swiped away, stolen by Tyron Lawrence. And the first offensive possession results in a turnover. Lawrence drives in, has the ball poked out of bounds. It'll stay Sunrise basketball.
Yeah. Great rotation by Usman.
Let's take a look at that three again.
Now swing the ball, wide open look. As we said, I guess threes are banks are open on Sundays.
Here's a three-pointer, and Ruth is going to rim out there for the offensive rebound. Nobody boxes out.
Oh, my.
And the big guy slams it.
Oh, my goodness. Got to put a body on him now. Got to keep him off the backboard. As we said, not a high shooting percentage either way in the first half. That offensive glass is going to be important, and there was a stick back right there for two.
That was a shot to try to go in there, but, boy, talk about that last play.
Yeah. Shot goes up. You got to find somebody. You know, here he comes. No one boxes out. My goodness, too easy right there.
And Sunrise driving in. The ball stolen away, poked away, and taken by Osmania. Nice job to come up with that steal.
Great pass. Unselfish play. Nice drop off right there. Zachary Usman for two. Reward the big man for running the floor. Great ball pressure right here. Great defensive stand right there by Zachary.
Sunrise back to defend and attacking Scotland Campus. He'll drive it and score.
Great drive right there by Dunbar. Basket for two. They deflected. It would have been goaltending if it didn't go in because he did hit that ball if it hit the rim.
Sunrise with the basketball. Down by five. There's Robinson. Pulls up for a long two. Can't get the rim. Offensive rebound kept alive by Kieta. Now he'll swing it up top for another three by Odin this time. That's no good. Scotland Campus clears.
There's another offensive rebound for Kieta. Scotland's going to do a better job keeping him off the backboard.
Zachary now for Woodrich. No, Barry has it. Barry pulls up free throw line, extended kick, and a shot to go. And this may be the rebound. Gets it now for Berry. Now for Woodrich, a three. That is off the mark, and he's out of bounds.
Yeah, he had to shoot that one quick. 1 second left on the shot clock. Had to shoot it quick. Again, attack that offensive glass. Get second opportunities. Out of bounds right here for Scotland.
Berry inbounds to Dunbar. Dunbar, the Iowa State commit. Can't get that. And the ball knocked out of bounds. Yeah. It'll stay Scotland Campus ball.
Yeah, Scotland made a little screen, the screener action there for Dunbar. Thought he was going to get the foul call, did not get it, was fortunate to get the ball back on a deflection. Dunbar pleading to the referee out here. He's getting nowhere. Falling on deaf ear.
Yeah, sometimes you don't get their ear, do you?
No. Referees have done this for a long time. You can beg as much as you want. You're not getting anywhere. After we move on, we move on.
Lawrence Berry set to inbounds. Gets it into Osmani, who tries the long-range three and gets it to go. How about that? He goes at 6'9".
That's the first time we've seen that in 2 days. Kade didn't even go out to guard. Didn't think he could make it, but it looked good to me.
Dare you to shoot. He drops it in. Now they're going to go guard him, perhaps. He makes it 43-35.
Yep, that's how basketball has changed. Those big step out and make threes like that, that's the evolution of the game of basketball. Great drive right there for Sunrise to score with the left hand.
Lawrence drives in and gets the field goal. That's his first of the game. And back to the other side, it's Scotland Campus. Dean Zachary pulls up in traffic and scores. Nicely done by the 2020 student from Salem, Wisconsin.
Yeah, great job playing within himself. About a 12-footer. Great decision offensively.
He's got eight. Lawrence now for Odin. In the hands of Fritz, back to Odin. Odin drives the baseline, goes up as a shot blocked, but they're going to call a foul.
Wow.
Let's take a look at that last drive.
Yep, tackle his left hand. He's going left every time. Someone's going to step in there, maybe try to take a charge on him. But a great take, great finish for the left.
So Jeremiah Odin at the line and makes the free throw. The Chicago, Illinois resident makes it 45-38.
Watch for a little pressure right here, Sunrise, after this made free throw.
And the free throw is good. Yeah, we've seen him do that, Coach, a couple of times in the first half.
Yeah, but it's a great opportunity to set your pressure because it's a dead ball situation after a made free throw. A little 2-2-1, three-quarter court, probably trying to take some time off the shot clock, try to slow down Scotland, don't allow them to get set offensively.
There's Barry by the mid-floor line, and then the ball kicked away by Sunrise inadvertently, and it'll stop the clock, and they'll be forced to inbounds.
Yep, did a great job. Only 20 seconds here left on the shot clock. Ball under the basket for Scotland.
Get into Osmani. Back up top for Zachary. Zachary spinning. Throws it for Barry. Drives in against Moore and gets called for traveling. You can't believe it.
Yeah, it goes right back to that made free throw down this end. We talked about 2-2-1 back man. Took all the time off the shot clock. Scotland had to rush it. You know, it turned the ball over. Scotland in their man-to-man defense. Pressure in the basketball. Communicating, switching all light screens.
And Sunrise going to pull up for a top-of-the-key three, no good. But how about that offensive rebound by Kieta?
Yeah, Zebras may have missed that one. I think it hit the pipe above the backboard, but it's a tough view for those referees.
He's trying to work his way in, cannot. And a very feisty defensive play by Norris Berry as he goes against two and kind of rips the ball away and then a whistle and a foul.
Yeah, Sunrise shot the ball and it popped up and hit the pipe. Yep, and I don't think the referee saw it. That's a tough one to see. I'm wearing glasses, so I have great eyes, and I was able to pick that one up.
Orange Berry attracting the attention, and Scotland Campus will get it back down by up by six.
Yep, Strickland coming back in the game here, looking for instant offense for Scotland.
Yeah, drive in, can't get the shot to go. Osmani, the rebound, puts it up, but gets fouled.
Great attack in the glass. Strickland drives the goal, misses the layup. Defenders rotate over. Usman rebound. He's got to finish that one. Missed a couple of them last night. He's got to gather himself, go strong, backboard. Two free throws for Usman here.
And he misses the first. We just saw him hit a three earlier, though. Showed some pretty good touch from outside for a guy that goes at 6'9", 260.
Yeah, he's going to stay on balance here. Shoot it straight up, straight down, hold that follow through. So you see how he falls off the line there? He gets off balance.
Played about 6 minutes here in the second half. Scotland with the lead. Sunrise with the basketball. Lawrence gives it a Moore, drives in, and gets fouled.
Yeah, great drive there. Woj is going to move his feet defensively, going to keep him out of the middle of the lane, going to force that ball back to the baseline.
Got to like the way they're attacking the rim, though.
Yeah, put their head down, drive. Guys got to carve out space. Scotland's going to do a better job moving their feet defensively.
Moore, 6'5", 200 pounds from North Little Rock.
Yeah, very, very, very athletic. Loves to put his head down and drive.
And he makes the first. Look at that drive again.
Here's Moore here on the wing. See, Wolders just going to move his feet. That's too easy.
45-40. Scotland Campus with the basketball.
It was only a matter of time.
You knew it, Coach.
Woolwich was going to make it. He was going to keep on shooting them. The rim was kind. Let's see if they can get him going. He got hot yesterday, made three in a row.
Now it's up to seven.
Let's see if Scotland can go back to him next time down defensively.
He's got an underneath. And the ball stripped away, stolen by Scotland Campus.
Find him in transition. Uh-oh, right back at you.
Long three that time by Jason Woodridge. I mean, that was way back. Couldn't get it to go, but was many there for the offensive rebound. He puts it up and in, and Sunrise will use the timeout. We will take it as well. The lead goes to 9 for the team. That's here from Bel Air, Kansas. Back to AIC in a moment.
Come on in and discover the new Cox Solutions store. Experience a whole new level of in-home comfort. It's all right here at the Cox Solutions Store. Discover, learn, and experience more.
Drone Racing League pilot Wild Willie is testing his skills on the scariest course imaginable. His mom's house. Fortunately, he's using panoramic Wi-Fi from Cox. Because even a 1 second delay could mean trouble for everyone. Wall-to-wall fast panoramic Wi-Fi from Cox. Wi-Fi at the speed of flight.
Jeff Tootley, Mike Burns for a first of a quadruple header. 4 games for you in 2020 Hoopall Prep Showcase. And Coach, your thoughts here for both sides here in the second half?
Yeah, this is a big spot right here for Sunrise coming out of a timeout. 9-point game. If they're not careful, Scotland can open this one up real quick on you.
Oh, wow. Nice near steal that time. Now he did get it. Yeah, terrific job.
Yeah, great hustle by Kieta right there.
Yeah, just goes in and gets it.
I'd like to see Sunrise throw that ball inside and see if we get Kieta an easy basket around the goal.
Sunrise trying to stay in this. A dangerous point of the game, down 9 here.
Force it offensively.
Yep, and now the home run pass to the cutting Dunbar. Can't pull it in cleanly. It's poked out of bounds. Last touch by Sunrise.
Yeah, again, Kieta's really working hard inside. He's got his man on his back. I'd like to see Sunrise throw that ball in there and see if he can score an easy basket for him. Usmani going one-on-one against Kieta. Offensive foul.
Yep.
Great job. Great job, absolutely. Great job by Kieta. Scotland looked like get a little stagnant there in that out-of-bounds play right there. Ball gets stuck in the corner there, and Usmani had to make a play for himself and get called for a charge.
In that situation, does he need to find someone to pass that ball out?
Yeah, guard's got to help him out and go get the ball, absolutely.
We'll take a look at that in a moment as well and see what he should have done in that situation. Lawrence has it meanwhile.
Let's see if Sunrise keeps their head up and tries to reward the big guy for taking that charge.
Mortigard has it. It's at left side for Jackson. Jackson tries to find Lawrence. Kicks it around left for Mortigard. Down in the paint. Kieta. The shot clock winding down. He nails the three.
Again, they finally throw the ball inside. It collapses the defense. Pitch the ball back out for wide open three. Usmani, great move there on the blocks going over his left shoulder.
Yep. Really impressive and matched up against a guy that is taller. On that left side, Lawrence tries the three. That's going to hit off the backboard, no good.
Again, that's a 4 shot right there for Sunrise.
Scotland Campus tries to respond, and Strickland has the ball poked out of bounds. Take a look again.
Yeah, here's that play. You can't let that big get stopped in the corner then. Watch Kieta slide his feet, stays low, straight up down. That's definitely definitely a charge. Usmani dropped the shoulder. Kieta took it on the chin, fell, going the other way. Uh-oh.
And he gets loose from about 15 feet out, but he misses the jumper, does Keelan Woodridge.
Woodridge isn't used to shooting twos. He'd rather shoot threes. Maybe two more steps back, that drops in. But a great view right there. Great eyes by the Zebra seeing that ball hit that pipe up top there.
Sunrise with the basketball, down 52-44. Rotengard nails that long two to make it 52-46.
Rotengard, nice shot. Came off that screen. Fall away. Swish.
Pretty impressive. In the 6'7 Norway native.
Yep, you can shoot the ball from the perimeter.
Trying to work it inside to Muhammad Wade. Can't get the shot to go. Rebound Strickland.
Yeah, that's Strickland just bringing energy, playing hard.
Strickland crosses over, gets the free throw line, and gets fouled.
Okay, whenever he's on the floor, I'm telling you, he's always making plays. He's always around the basketball, maybe a bit undersized, but he's always bringing energy for that Scotland team.
Just about 10 minutes to play here in the game. This game number one of four. We've got Northfield Mount Hermon against Mount Zion Prep next.
Yep, Scotland right now. Coach Cheney giving some guys some rest here, going to his bench. We'll see what works out here.
No, inbounds, but Wade can't get the shot to go, and a foul on the rebound. Ball poked out of bounds on the rebound.
Well, you gotta make that basket right there.
Yeah,
Wade gets,
right,
yeah, exactly. He's a little nervous about Kiata blocking a shot, but you got to finish that one.
Merriweather set to inbound, does so, and some traffic, and it's stolen away by,
yeah,
Sunrise.
Great hustle by Rotengard right there, hitting the floor.
There's Lawrence for Moore. Drives in, puts it off the window and in. Boy.
Yeah, super athlete. He gets himself in the lane, shoots a floater for two.
And Strickland has it once again. He loves the basketball in his hands. Just outside the left elbow, tries the jumper. Can't get it to go. Offensive rebound taken in by Dunbar. Dunbar throws it up off the window, no good. Another offensive rebound by Scotland Campus. Now a three by Merriweather, no good. Another offensive rebound. Now Strickland's going to try the three, and he hits.
We talked about it at halftime. That offensive glass is imperative. Whoever wins that battle is going to win the basketball game. Three opportunities, four opportunities. Scotland knocked down Strickland for three.
He's got nine. It's 55-48.
Great ball pressure right here by Scotland. They may have to call a timeout.
Yep, you called it, Coach.
Yep, you get lucky right there. Coach had to bail him out. Great defense right there by Scotland.
Timeout on the floor. Scotland 55, Sunrise 48 here at AIC. Fifty-five, 48, 9:15 to go, and Scotland leading Sunrise. And Coach, your thoughts on both of these teams?
Yeah, 7-point game right here coming out of this timeout. Let's see what Sunrise does. I'd like to see him throw the ball inside. Right now, Strickland's out there for Scotland. Coach Shane went to the bench, and he's bringing some energy defensively. Let's see what happens this last 9:13.
And Sunrise in traffic, can't get the shot to go, and wait, Scotland, Kevin, they're just kind of relentless the way they come away with it, and then kind of a broken play. Sunrise,
wow,
comes up with it.
The head coach, AC for Sunrise, get a little bit upset, swung his hand, didn't realize he had his pen, his X and O pen in his hand. It shot across the floor. I don't know if anyone needs a magic marker, but there's one out there.
Scotland Campus with the basketball and the lead as we approach the 8-minute mark.
It's Strickland drives, gets a defense clap, pitches the ball in the corner, Dunbar for three. Strickland, again, just always making things happen.
Sunrise with the basketball now. They can get a field goal here. Lawrence driving in all the way to the rim as he attacks and scores.
Again, Lawrence is always going hard left. Scotland's going to step up and pin that ball in his right hand.
And then right side is Scotland campus. There's Wig inside. Can't get the shot to go. And
great contest there defensively for Sunrise. Block going in transition.
Couldn't get it there. And now
that's all
Scotland
he knows.
Scotland campus trying to come back.
Yeah, well, all Strickland knows is just put his head down and drive. He's always in attack mode. Always in attack mode. I'm going to tell you, some low Division I school,
right,
get a really, really good player if you're able to pull that kid off. Really enjoy watching him play. Tough to find a kid like that that just brings energy. As a head coach, you'd love to have a kid like that on your roster.
Scotland campus sent a long two that time from the big guy Osmani. Can't get the shot to go, and Sunrise able to pull down that rebound.
Lawrence got to go back to that left hand. Scotland did a better job forcing him right, makes him uncomfortable.
Just outside of the free throw line, but didn't get it in a net that time. Good. Michael Robinson, and
I don't know if there was a draft. Someone opened the window, but we had an air ball.
That was
know.
A little bit, yeah.
I don't know what happened. I don't know if someone opened the door and a breeze came through and knocked that thing down like a dead quail.
It happens, right? Scotland campus with the basketball and an eight-point lead with just 7 minutes remaining. And there another air ball down the other side. That time Jaden Zachary couldn't get the rim. Sunrise tries to go back, had the ball swatted away, and Zachary comes up with it. There's Zachary driving in, and he gets fouled.
Yeah, maybe a good foul in transition. Looked like Scott was going to go ahead and get a layup, so you follow that guy, stop that break.
Scotland campus will inbound. Zachary has it. Move to Basie. He's seen Basie from Seattle. Playing prep school in Scotland, Pennsylvania. Now Woodridge tries the three, side of the rim, no good. And
Sunrise has done a phenomenal job defending Woodridge today.
Yeah,
haven't given him any open looks. Great job defensively right there.
Ball nearly poked away. Moore comes up and then pulls up just inside the free throw line and scores.
Again, that's what Moore loves doing, get in the lane, attacking, loves playing downhill. Tough shot.
58-52 the score. Back the other side, and Zachary tries long two. He can't get the shot to go. And timer Jackson the rebound for Sunrise. And try to cut into a six-point deficit. Jackson can't get the shot to go, grabs his own rebound, and now Robinson tries a three. That will rim out, and Scotland campus clears. That's Norris Berry pulling in with both hands.
Tough spot right there. That would have been a big spot right there for Sunrise.
Zachary gets it off to Basie. Looks an inside out of Berry, matched up against some of the bigger trees, able to pull it up, but can't get the shot to go, and rebound taken in by Sunrise, and now it's stolen back by Scotland campus. And a 2-2 break. Berry gets the feed and kisses it off the window and in.
Great take, great take. Get yourself in the lane, score two.
Timeout on the floor. 5:13 to go in this one. 60-52, Scotland leads Sunrise here in Springfield.
Come on in and discover the new Cox Solutions store. Experience a whole new level of in-home comfort. It's all right here at the Cox Solutions store. Discover, learn, and experience more.
Drone Racing League pilot Wild Willie is testing his skills on the scariest course imaginable. His mom's house. Fortunately, he's using panoramic Wi-Fi from Cox. Because even a 1 second delay could mean trouble for everyone. Wall-to-wall fast panoramic Wi-Fi from Cox. Wi-Fi at the speed of flight.
And a look at Sunrise Christian School out of Bel Air, Kansas. They're in Springfield this weekend. A terrific season so far, 18 wins against 5 losses. And, well, Mike Burns, this is a terrific game. They're down by 8 with 5 minutes to go, but back and forth. Great energy, I think, for both teams, both Sunrise Christian and Scotland Campus.
Yeah, I like the time out there by Coach Cheney. Score 2, spread it to 8, give his guys a rest, filter back in his starters, and see if they can put Sunrise away in this last 5 minutes.
Tyron Lawrence with the basketball for Sunrise. Gets it off to Mordegard. Mordegard's going to fire a 3. Back of the rim, no good. Offensive rebound kept alive by Robinson. And another 3 will pop out. Another offensive rebound. Now Lawrence gets it back to Rodegaard, who's going to drive in, initiate the contact, and draw the foul.
Wow.
Now, too many offensive rebounds here.
Yeah, we talked about it at the half. They're going to have to rebound the basketball. Scotland doesn't box out. Yep. He's going to step up and rebound the ball both ends of the floor. Too many offensive rebounds. Too many second chance opportunities. A lot of times guys get caught watching the basketball. Mm-hmm. Just put a body on your man, rebound the ball.
Sunrise has it. Fritz now for Rodegaard, who tries the 3, can't get it to go.
Yeah, and Sunrise shoots 4 threes in succession. Haven't looked at Kieta at all. I don't understand it. I don't know if they came out of a timeout saying, let's try to make some threes and get the game close.
Now, you got plenty of time.
Absolutely.
It's an 8-point game.
Let's play inside out and reward the big kid for playing so hard.
Especially you got one of the terrific bigs in this game, Blaise Kieta, goes at 6'10".
Absolutely. I'm telling you right now, there are a lot of Division I schools here that want to see that kid play. Let's get him involved offensively.
There's Woodward. It had it poked away. Coach, Sunrise comes up with it.
Coach Cheney on the side may have taken a charge or a block. I'm not really sure. And one of Sunrise's players, Lawrence, bumped into him going up the sideline. Coach Cheney stepped in. I don't know if it was a charge or a block. We're going to have to see if we can get that on camera.
Wow.
Oh, my goodness.
That doesn't tickle, I'm sure, right?
No, he's smiling over there on the sideline. He hit something funny. My goodness. He looks like he's okay. He looks like he's okay, though. If we get that on camera, I think you're going to enjoy that shot. You let me know if you think that was a block or a charge.
All right, here's Tyron Lawrence. Gets it now to Rodegaard, nails the long 2 just in front of the 3-point stripe.
Again, I like the shot, but let's either step back and shoot a 3 or get in the lane more and get a closer shot. One of the worst shots in basketball. Rick Pitino would always say that. Worst shot in basketball when you're standing on the 3-point line. Step back a half a step or get into about 12, 15 feet. Good shot. Not upset with it, but just take a 3 if you can.
Sure. Here's Berry, who works his way in for a basket. He makes it 62-54 with just over 3 minutes to play.
Yeah, Sunrise cannot exchange buckets right now. They have to get successions of stops if they want to get back in this ball game.
Fritz now for a Kieta, works his way in and gets fouled. So finally, the big guy gets the touch. Hey, let's take a look at that last play you were talking about.
All right, people at home, you let me know if Coach Cheney, if it's a charge or a block here on the sideline.
Position, right?
Did he? I don't know. I thought his feet were moving. But he's okay. He's happy with this 8-point spread right here.
Okay, now that might hurt in a few hours, right, when that swells up.
Again, 2 possessions in a row. They throw it inside to the big. They get water, take it out of bounds, throw it inside to the big. They get a dunk. Great possession.
Flush.
Great
using possession. That 6'10 frame.
Great possession right there.
He's got 6 in the game.
Telling you, Lawrence subs in, gets the ball. Strickland subs in, drives, gets us out the free throw line. Yeah, here's Sunrise possession down this end, taking advantage of the size. Dropped the ball off to Keita, high percentage shot. Wear him out.
Pick and roll,
yeah,
huh?
Wear him out. Wear him out. Throw it into him. Right now, Coach Chaney has Usmani out of the game, so you really have a matchup problem down the other end for Scotland. So throw the ball inside and reward the big fella.
So Tyrell Strickland at the free throw line makes his first and puts his team up 63-56. He's got 10.
He's an energized bunny whenever he comes in the game, offensively, defensively. He's always making plays, always around the ball. He's talking to teammates. Again, he's going to be a great, great get for some low Division I program. Scotland coming out in a zone right here, maybe trying to protect the paint.
There's a three off the mark, and the rebound taken in by Scotland. So Sunrise does go one and done, and Strickland has it. Well, you're right, though. He's the quarterback out there.
It's
Strickland controls the game.
Yeah, he gets in there and just always in attack mode.
Well, he pulls up for a long two that time. No good. Rebound, Mikel Robinson. Off to Lawrence. Trying to get it to Rodegaard.
Great pass. Great swing.
More. And a right wing 3-0, but nylon as Tyron Lawrence cashes in.
Again, they throw the ball inside of Keita. Defense collapses. He pitches out of it. Extra pass. Three. Give him a hockey assist.
He's in double figures, and now it is a 5-point game with 2:12 to go and a timeout called. We'll step aside as well. 2:12 remaining. 64-59. Scotland leads Sunrise here in Springfield.
Come on in and discover the new Cox Solutions store. Experience a whole new level of in-home comfort. It's all right here at the Cox Solutions store. Discover, learn, and experience more.
Drone Racing League pilot Wild Willie is testing his skills on the scariest course imaginable. His mom's house. Fortunately, he's using panoramic Wi-Fi from Cox. Because even a 1 second delay could mean trouble for everyone. Wall-to-wall fast panoramic Wi-Fi from Cox. Wi-Fi at the speed of flight.
Five-point game, 2:12 to go, and let's take a look at that ball movement.
Throw the ball inside, defense collapses, swing, wide open three in the corner. Again,
great
Sunrise,
rotation,
yeah, play inside out, use that big. My esteemed colleague right here, Jeff Dooley, just brought up a great idea. Looked in the crowd, saw Rod Strickland, former NBA great. I have a feeling that may be Strickland's father.
Probably, you would think, right?
Yeah, Tampa, Florida, absolutely. Same type of energy it brings to the table.
After the miss, Sunrise has it, works it inside to Yate, but it's taken away, taken by Strickland. There's Tyrell Strickland, 5'11", 170.
Yes. Scotland going to take some time off the clock. Again, make sure to play your style of play. High percentage shots right here. Let's see who steps up and makes a big play for Scotland here offensively.
Strickland's going to drive in, kick it right side for a very long two. No good, and the rebound taken in by Mikel Robinson of Sunrise.
Pretty good look there.
Now Fritz tries the three and gets it to go right in front of his own bench. A deep three from the left corner.
Huge shot. Throw it ahead in transition. 3-2-point game.
How about that? 1 minute to go, and it's a 2-point game. Fasten your seatbelts.
Yeah, we couldn't ask for anything more.
Been a great basketball game here. First of four on your TV.
Again, Scotland taking the air out of the ball right here. Let's see where they go. Coach Chaney calls the timeout. Let's see what he diagrams out of the timeout.
We'll step aside as well. A 2-point game here at AIC. You're watching the 2020 Hoopaw Prep Showcase. Well, back to live action. You see Strickland pull up just inside the free throw line. Couldn't get the shot to go. And Sunrise grabs the rebound, a chance to tie here. Driving in all the way to the rim, and he does so. Terrific job by Tyron Lawrence, the 6'4 guard from Morgan County, Georgia. He just explodes to the rim.
Here we go. 2-for-1 down there. Sunrise scores quick, so they get the ball back again. They're going to have the last possession. Let's see what happens right here for Scotland. 25 seconds to go. Let's see where they go offensively here. Watch for a late high ball screen, maybe a pitch in the corner for a three. Ball's in Strickland's hand.
Five seconds on the shot clock.
Pitch back, deep three. Oh, my goodness.
Woodridge can't get the shot to go. Goes out of bounds. Last touch by Sunrise. It'll stay Scotland basketball.
Scotland calls timeout. 9 seconds. Ball under the basket. Yep.
I'm going to stay here. Let's take a look at that last play.
Yeah. He's always going. He's always going to his left hand. Got himself to the rim. Tied the ball game up. But here we go now. Scotland under the basket. Timeout out of timeout. We're going. What type of set is he going to run?
Well, bring us in both huddles, Coach, with 9 seconds to go.
Yeah, real quick, what are we going to do defensively on the Sunrise side, and what are we going to do offensively on the Scotland side? He's had 700 wins. Coach Chaney knows what he's doing. He's got to have something up his sleeve.
And how do you defend this?
Well, I'd like to force the ball in the corner. I assume they're going to go man-to-man. You just got to get a stop. Someone's got to make a play.
And you look at the Sunrise bench, and they're going to get the play call as well. A terrific game between Sunrise Christian of Bel Air and Scotland Campus from Scotland, Pennsylvania.
We talked about this when we came out of the half. Offensive glass. Watch what happens right now. Scotland gets a shot off with maybe 5 seconds to go. Just watch for an offensive rebound. If not, we're going to go for bonus basketball.
'64, 9 seconds to play.
Yep. Sunrise in a man-to-man.
Noah Berry will inbounds. He's got Strickland right underneath the basket. We're going to sub out.
Yeah. That referee, it's a right call. The referee, you can't make a late sub right there. He's got to come back in. They don't like that matchup with Kieter up there.
Yeah, Kieter.
Smart play. Calls a timeout.
Now he'll get him in.
Yeah.
And we'll take a break right here. Come back with the conclusion next here in Springfield.
Come on in and discover the new Cox Solutions store. Experience a whole new level of in-home comfort. It's all right here at the Cox Solutions store. Discover, learn, and experience more.
Drone Racing League pilot Wild Willie is testing his skills on the scariest course imaginable. His mom's house. Fortunately, he's using panoramic Wi-Fi from Cox. Because even a 1 second delay could mean trouble for everyone. Wall-to-wall fast panoramic Wi-Fi from Cox. Wi-Fi at the speed of flight.
Well, it's been a dandy game one of four. We've got for you on your TV the 2020 Hoopall Prep Showcase in Scotland Campus. We'll have the basketball underneath the basket they're shooting at with a game tied. 9 seconds to play. Norman's Berry gets it in. Rolling in Dunbar. There's Dunbar spinning in, driving as the ball poked away. Still loose on the floor. Grabbed by Sunrise. Time expires and we are heading to overtime.
Great job defensively right there by Sunrise. We're going into overtime.
We will take a break, come back with the extra session next. It is Scotland 64, Sunrise 64, here in AIC.
Come on in and discover the new Cox Solutions store. Experience a whole new level of in-home comfort. It's all right here at the Cox Solutions store. Discover, learn, and experience more.
Drone Racing League pilot Wild Willie is testing his skills on the scariest course imaginable. His mom's house. Fortunately, he's using panoramic Wi-Fi from Cox. Because even a 1 second delay could mean trouble for everyone. Wall-to-wall fast panoramic Wi-Fi from Cox. Wi-Fi at the speed of flight.
Well, bonus money's worth for the fans here today and the coaches as well. They come from all over the country to watch the 2020 Hoopaw Prep Showcase and Sunrise Christian in Scotland campus going to the extra session, Mike.
Yep, Lawrence makes that drive and scores, ties the game up at 64. The first time the score was tied the whole second half. So here we go, 5 minutes of bonus basketball. Let's see if Sunrise plays inside out and rewards Keita for the job he's done defensively. Who's going to be that guy that's going to step up and make that big-time play?
Yep, Keita jumps it up again to Smani. And it's Scotland campus back to defend as Sunrise Christian wins the tap. And a steal, and Scotland comes up with it. There's underneath Dunbar working in, leaves it for the cutting Usman. He can't finish.
Dunbar takes stick back. Usmani layup rolls out.
It.
Dunbar around the goal, tips it back in.
Scotland. That's when you have size around the basket, right?
Yeah. Scotland goes up, tips it back, gets the early lead.
16 points for him, and how about that? Scotland back in command.
Sunrise standing around a little bit offensively.
They led most of the second half, and actually a lot of the first half as well. Sunrise, a nice job to come back to force overtime. There's more drives in, throws it up. Can't get the shot to go. Usmani pulls down the rebound.
Yeah, great defensive stand by Scotland. I'd like to see Sunrise move the ball, play inside out. Scotland with the ball up two, 4 minutes to go in overtime.
Well, Michael Robinson with the basketball now for Sunrise. Sunrise drives in, trying to feed it off to the big guy, Usmani, and stolen away by Tyron Lawrence. Lawrence goes coast to coast, gets to the rim and scores.
Yeah, a little Euro move. He knew he had to get back to his left hand. But
another
great
tie,
job.
66 all. Garland Stone Dunbar, who's going to Iowa State. He's from Charlotte, North Carolina. Gets it to Tyrell Strickland. And here's Strickland, set to make his move. Passes right side for Woodridge. Back to Strickland. Off to Dunbar. A three is good. Wow. How about that long three that time with the defender out there? Garland Stone Dunbar.
Cream,
showing some range.
Yeah, Cream rising to the top. Steve Fromm's going to be really, really happy to have him at Iowa State this next 4 years. Big time shot.
He's got 19 now to lead all scorers. Let's see if Sunrise responds.
And he has all five of the overtime points.
There's Robinson. Gets it. Try to work it inside. The ball poked out of bounds. Last touch by Scotland of State Sunrise basketball. Let's take a look again.
Big time players make big time plays. Hand down, man down. Three in your eye.
Almost like he was daring him to shoot it out there. And he says, okay, I can make that shot. There's a three for Sunrise. That was T.J. Fritz, the 6'3 guard from Kansas, missing.
And Dunbar with the rebound, making big-time plays at big-time moments.
Scotland campus.
Looks like Coach Chaney's going to play through Dunbar to finish this one out. He hasn't won 700 wins, over 700 wins for nothing.
Zachary has it.
Great
pass. Gives it inside to the dunk.
Zachary did a great job probing the lane. Got the defender to come over, drop off, dunk.
71-66, and now Sunrise needs to score. There's more drives in and a foul. Fans want to travel, but
it was definitely a travel, but got away with it. Looks like a three-point play right here. Great drive by Zachary. Gets a big to come over and help. Drop off, dunk. Ooh. Great pass, great finish.
Noah Butler going, I should say, Colin Moore going to the free throw line. A 6'5", 200-pound Ford from North Little Rock,
yep.
Arkansas.
Old-fashioned three right there. Got a two-point game, 2 minutes to go.
One possession game, as you say, 2 minutes to play. Here's
little,
the big guy, Usmani.
Little token pressure, Sunrise. Takes the time off the shot clock. 20 seconds left to the shot clock. Two-point game, under 2 minutes to go.
And Dunbar has it for Scotland. Garland Stone Dunbar moving right, followed there by Moore. Loses the handle, the ball goes out of bounds, and it's going to be a turnover. Sunrise gets it back down a pair.
Again, a little stagnant there offensively. Want to take some time off the clock, but you got to stay in your offense. Got to run something.
There's Tyron Lawrence, the Georgia native, moving left. Drives in, hangs in the air, off the window and in. Lane opens up, and he takes it all the way to the backboard.
You said it again, moving left. He's going left. Scotland's going to take that left hand away. Tie game, minute 20.
There's Jaden Zachary with it. Gets it to Garland Stone Dunbar. Dunbar for Zachary. A three. It's good. Jaden Zachary hits the triple.
Wow.
Shows up three fingers, pumps his hand as he has put his team in front.
What a
time. He's got 11.
What a time to step up to drop a three. My goodness.
Timeout on the floor, 74-71. Scotland looking to get an OT win here in Springfield.
Come on in and discover the new Cox Solution Store. Experience a whole new level of in-home comfort. It's all right here at the Cox Solution Store. Discover, learn, and experience more.
Drone Racing League pilot Wild Willie is testing his skills on the scariest course imaginable. His mom's house. Fortunately, he's using panoramic Wi-Fi from Cox. Because even a 1 second delay could mean trouble for everyone. Wall-to-wall fast panoramic Wi-Fi from Cox. Wi-Fi at the speed of flight.
Jeff Dooley, Mike Burns here in Springfield. What a terrific basketball game. The 2020 Hoop Hall Prep Showcase, our first of four. The game won in overtime. And with a minute to play, Sunrise with the basketball down by three.
Scotland, Coach Chaney comes out in a zone. Wow. Veteran move by Coach Chaney. Throwing
a
curveball.
Good shot here as Fritz lets one fly from long range. No good. And Scotland campus pulls down the rebound.
3-point game. 45 seconds to go. Sunrise has to get a stop here.
Yeah, this would make it a two-possession game if Scotland can put the ball in the hoop. Here's Zachary trying to get by Fritz. Zachary still with a dribble. Passes by him, now reverses. Gets it off to Strickland. Strickland picks up the dribble. Now Dunbar has it. There's Zachary driving in all the way to the rim. Initiates the contact and a foul call.
Shoot it 1-on-1. Yep, use that whole shot clock. Drive the lane. That's a tough matchup for Sunrise.
Zachary showing good ball
handling
skills.
Zachary stepping up big here. We talked about it before. Who was going to make the big plays down the stretch? Again, this is what college coaches want to see. College coaches love moments like this. See guys in adverse situation. Who's going to step up and make big plays?
Zachary at the line, and he makes the first and puts his team up now by four. That's big, a two-possession
game
now.
The rim was kind.
Kind of hit the front end and then fell through. Second one much better as he line drives it through.
They don't need a three here. Let's get some drive to the basket, maybe get to the free throw line. Scotland still sitting in that zone. It's going to be tough for Sunrise to drive the ball. Someone's going to step up and make a big shot.
And a three misses that time, and Scotland campus able to get the rebound, and that will do it.
Again, Dunbar with the rebound to ice this thing, 76-71. Great basketball game.
Boy, he played well today, did Dunbar. Ends up finishing with 19 points as Scotland campus wins it, 76-71 the final score. We'll take a break and back with our coach and our player of the game on Your View.
Come on in and discover the new Cox Solution Store. Experience a whole new level of in-home comfort. It's all right here at the Cox Solution Store. Discover, learn, and experience more.
Drone Racing League pilot Wild Willie is testing his skills on the scariest course imaginable. His mom's house. Fortunately, he's using panoramic Wi-Fi from Cox. Because even a 1 second delay could mean trouble for everyone. Wall-to-wall fast panoramic Wi-Fi from Cox. Wi-Fi at the speed of flight.
Yeah. and tell us a little bit about how you guys won in overtime.
We just stuck together. Before the overtime, I told my team we just got to play hard and play as a group. And that's what we did, and we won in overtime.
Well, you seem like you love to be out on that court and just kind of relentless today, going back and forth with both sides.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I love being on the court. I love being with my teammates. But without my teammates, I would never play like that. So I'm just going to get a game to my teammates and my coaches.
How fun is it for you guys to be in a tournament like this and play against some great competition?
Oh, it's very fun.